warming or climate change, as it is now referred to, is an issue that affects all living creatures on this planet. Let's focus on just one marine mammal that is currently under threat. According to Steven Amstrup, greenhouse gas mitigation can reduce sea ice loss and increase polar persistence, 2007 research paper, the effect that the increase of greenhouse gas is having on the Arctic sea ice indicates polar bear population to be decimated. Or does it? Using a Bayesian network model, a graphical model that shows probable outcomes from desired variables, Amstrup used 4 greenhouse gas scenarios, 4 eco-regions, 4 habitat variables and 4 future time decade periods to conduct an experiment that would predict the future outcomes if changes to greenhouse gas emissions were to be put in place. The 4 greenhouse gas scenarios consisted of A1B, business as usual, B1, Y2K, 2000 level climate change commitment, and MIT, 5-round mitigation ensemble. The 4 eco-regions were made up of the seasonal ice region that runs along the Canadian border, the archipelago region made up of the Canadian Arctic Islands, the divergent region which runs along the Russian border to the Barents Sea, and the convergent ice region that runs along Greenland. These regions are home to the vast majority of polar bear populations, in total some 23,000 bears. The habitat variables were made up of optimal habitat, total shelf ice habitat, seasonal change in habitat, which was seen as one of the most important variables, and shelf to ice distance. The 4 future time decade periods range between 2020 to 2099. To illustrate these results of several years of research, I've compiled the following slides but put them in a nutshell. These results show that if the A1B scenario were to continue, that the diversity of a polar bear's habitat range would diminish significantly as there would be less food resources readily available, weaker ice, greater distances to travel, and a double time frame of ice-free summer months. If any mitigation scenarios were to be put in place, the effect of these results would at least be halved. This next graph shows that if the A1B scenario were to be kept in place, the effects of climate change would occur a lot earlier at significantly higher outcome probabilities than if any of the mitigation scenarios were to be put in place. This report was cited by 14 relevant reports, with 13 out of 14 agreeing with Amstrup's findings, with no further updates or opinions. There was one article, however, that believed that the ice-free summer months would start sooner, within the next 20 years, instead of within the next 35 to 40 years. So as an overall result, it can be seen that if there are no changes to current greenhouse gas emissions, by 2045, ice-free summer months would have more than doubled, and the weakness and dispersion of the sea ice would have major impacts on the polar bear population. However, the effect of climate change can be reduced through greenhouse gas mitigation, which will then reduce the effects on the Arctic sea ice, resulting in a steady, possibly increasing polar bear population.